您现在收看的是华视教育文化频道，
接下来要播出的是英语绘画二。
大家好，我是黄雅玲，欢迎收看我们今天的英语绘画 English Conversation， 是第十七讲旅游篇四的转播。那我们今天要讲授的对话呢，乃是关于说出国旅游的时候呢，跟朋友遇到的一个相关话题。那这个内容呢，我们会以短句的方式来秀给各位同学看。但在美的短句开始之前，同样的，我们还是会先进行我们短句中所谓使用到的单字的解释。在知道了单字的意思之后呢，当我们在看对话的时候，就可以比较快的清楚知道内容了。好，那我们先来看看我们对话中所会使用到的单字。第一个 ，zong， 名词，黎明或者是拂晓。我们来看一下它的例句 ：We must get up at dawn。我们必须天一亮就起来。Okay, number two, dusk. Dusk, 名词，黄昏或者是薄暮。来看一下它的例句。He worked from dawn till dusk. 他从早工作到晚。Okay, number three, waste. Waste, 名词，浪费、滥用。来看一下它的例句。Doing such a job is a waste of his talents. 做这种工作是在浪费他的才能。好，下一个单字呢是 decide. Decide, 动词，决定、决议。来看一下他的例句。She decided to live in London. 她决定住在伦敦。好，下一个单字呢是 spectacular， spectacular， 名词，奇观、壮观。我们要说它的例句呢，例句呢提到了 the view is spectacular， 那景观真是壮丽到不行。好，下一个单字的部分呢是 leisure， 形容词。空闲的，来看一下它的例句。What do you usually do in your leisure time? 你通常在空闲时间做些什么呢 ？Okay, next, literally, literally, 副词，倒字面的，逐字的。我们来看一下它的例句。Do not translate an article literally. 不要照字面来直译一篇文章。下一个单字是 admire. Admire, 动词，称赞。来看一下我们的例句。He admired her new coat. 他赞美她的新大衣。OK， 下一个单字呢是 panoramic， panoramic， 形容词，全景的，活动画景的。来看一下的例句。There is a panoramic restaurant on the top floor of the hotel. 这个饭店的顶楼呢，有一个全景餐厅。来看下一个单字 ，encompass。Encompass, 动词，围绕，包围。来看一下它的例句。The enemy encompassed the city. 敌人包围了这个城市。 下一个单字呢是 limited， 形容词，有限的，不多的。来看一下它的例句的部分。The amount of money we have is limited. 我们的钱有限。OK， 下一个单字呢是 accidentally。accidentally， 副词，偶然的，意外的。来看一下它的例句。I met her accidentally. 我无意中遇到她。好，最后一个单字呢是 cuisine。cuisine， 名词，烹饪，菜肴。来看一下它的例句。We are going to eat India cuisine tonight. 我们今晚要吃印度料理。好，单字的部分呢，我们就先介绍到这个地方了。接下来，请各位跟我一起来观赏一下这则简短的 VCR。
Ifra, what a surprise! I never expect to see you here.
Me either. Why are you here? Vacation too?
I hope so. No, I'm here for a business trip.
To work on such beautiful day? What a pity! Then I shall enjoy my holidays and you may enjoy your working, haha.
Oh, that's nice. Luckily, I'm not as busy as last time I worked in Korea. I had to work from dawn till dusk. Korea loved to work. I can still find some time to rest in the sunshine here this time.
Then you should.You know, France is such a beautiful country, and you should really visit some scenic spots. Or it is a waste to be here without seeing.
I know, but I didn't decide where to go first yet. Which spot have you already paid a visit?
Actually, I just arrived here the day before yesterday, so I didn't have time to go anywhere yet. But I was on the Eiffel Tower this morning.The scenery was so amazing that I would never forget for the rest of my life.
It must be great. I wish I could have the same experience too. How's the view on top of there?
The view is spectacular. It's hard to explain it by words. You should have seen it through your eyes once, since you are in France now. For me, I feel like becoming a more open-minded person after viewing such beautiful scenery.
Sounds great. I would definitely give it a try during my leisure time.
Look at this picture I took this morning. It is worthy to visit there, and you can easily get a whole picture of Paris from the top of there.
Aren't you scared while looking down from the top of the Eiffel Tower because the tower is so high?
Not if you look down, literally. You actually look in the far away distance and in all directions.You would simply admire how panoramic it is.
Sounds like being encompassed by a scenic dream.
And you will have the same feeling when you are in the midst of masterpieces of the Palace of Louvre.
You have been to the Louvre too?
Yes, that's my schedule of yesterday.
It's often said that one day isn't enough for the Louvre. Do you think that's true after you've been there yourself?
I couldn't agree more.There's a possibility that 1 week or more would be needed, but none of us can have so much time for that, can we?
You can say that again. By the way, if you're not quite busy at this moment, perhaps you could do me a favor.
Depends. What kind of help do you need?
Well, as you know, I'm a clothes designer, and I'm looking for someone to wear my clothes for photo shooting.That's the reason why I'm on the street now. Are you interested?
I'm not sure. Can I think about it for a couple days?
Oh dear, time's limited. I need a model as soon as I can. Oops, a meeting is about to start, and I have to leave now.
Sure, wish you luck. You should be quick. Don't be late for the meeting.
Thanks. Hey, think about the modeling thing, okay?And it's nice to see you here.
I think so, too. You can always feel warm when you've met your friend accidentally in a foreign country.
I will call you later today. Maybe we could have some French cuisine together this evening.
I'm looking forward to it. See you.
欢迎回来。在我们看完了刚刚 VCR 之后，不知道各位同学有没有清楚刚刚我们的剧中到底说了些什么？不清楚的话也没有关系，我们也是会一句一句慢慢的拆开来看的。好，我们来看看对话。So Sam started. Hey Flora, what a surprise! I never expect about seeing you here. 他说 ：“Hey Flora, 好巧哦，从来没有想过我能在这里遇上你耶。” Flora said, "Me either. Why you here? Vacation too?" 他说：“我也都从来没有想过能够遇到你呀、啊，你也是一样来度假的吗？” But Sam said, "Oh, I hope so, but no, no.I'm here for a business trip." 他说我也很希望我是啊，不过呢，我是为了公事来的，我是来出差的呢。So Flora said, "To work on such a beautiful day, what a pity! Then I shall enjoy my holidays, and you may enjoy your working." 哈哈，他说在这么美好的日子，你竟然要上班，我真是同情你呀、啊。那我就更应该要好好享受我的假期，那你就认真的去工作吧。好，我们来做个补充，关于 such。such 我们如果说要使用它来做感叹的时候，中文也就是多么的或者是如此的的意思。英文呢，我们会是 such 加上一个名词片语，或者是 so 加上一个形容词，再加上一个名词片语，或者是 how 加上一个形容词，再加上一个名词片语，或者是 what 加上一个名词片语。那其实很混乱，其实它蛮简单，只有两种模式。第一个呢，关于 how 跟 what 呢，其实多半放在于句首，而 so 跟 such 多半放在句中的部分。我们来举一个例子好了，如果我们要说这是个多么美丽的花园呐、啊，我们可以讲 It is such a beautiful garden。我们也可以讲说 It is so beautiful a garden。或者呢，我们还可以讲什么呢？What a beautiful garden it is. 或者是 How beautiful garden it is. 好，这四种用法呢，都是用来强调说它是多么美的花园呐。那因为 how 跟我们的 so 呢，都是一个感叹副词的状态，所以我们的后面一定要有一个形容词来让它修饰。所以原本一个完整的名词片语 a beautiful garden。这中间呢，它的形容词 beautiful 在到 so 跟遇到 how 的时候，都会通通被提到最前面去做一个修饰的动作。A what 跟 such 它们都是一个感叹形容词的部分，所以它们可以直接修饰一个完整的片语。A beautiful garden。好，我们再回到我们对话的部分。Sam said, "Oh, that's nice." 他说，哦，你也太好心了吧，是非常讽刺的一种用法。接下来他说到了 Luckily, I'm not as busy as last time I worked in Korea. I had to work from dawn till dusk. Koreans love to work. I can still find some time to rest in the sunshine here this time. 他说幸好这次工作并不像在韩国那么的忙，那是在韩国真的是从天亮就一直忙忙忙到天黑了，因为韩国人热爱工作。可是这次呢，在法国我还是有机会可以享受到这里的阳光的。So Flora said, "Then you should. You know, France is such a beautiful country, and you should really visit some scenic spots, or it is a waste to be here without visiting." 他说：“那你就应该要好好的享受啊，你知道的，法国是个如此美丽的国家，你真的应该要去参观一些观光景点，否则真是浪费了。” So Sam said, "I know, but I didn't decide where to go first yet. Which spot have you already paid a visit?" 他说，可我还想好要去哪个景点呢。他就问了，那你去过哪些景点了呢？ Then Flora said, "Actually, I just arrived here the day before yesterday. So I didn't have time to go anywhere yet." 那事实上，我前天也到法国的，我还没有什么时间可以好好的来参观一下这边。But I was on the Eiffel Tower this morning. 他说我早上呢在埃菲尔铁塔这边。The scenery was so amazing that I would never forget for the rest of my life. 他说呢，我早上去过埃菲尔铁塔之后，我觉得那里的景致真的是太美了，一辈子应该都忘不掉了。我们来对这个 scenery 做一个补充。scenery 呢，它是一个不可数名词，指的是一个整个的风景。那跟它很像的叫做是 scene，S-C-E-N-E 的部分，这是一个可数名词，可以用来指场景、指部分的风景，或者是指一个景象。那常常跟这些单字混合在一起搞混的就是一个 view 了。我们说 view 是什么呢？ view 是指我们从观看者所处的角度所看出去的视野，其实指的是我们观看者放眼所及的一个范围，也就是我们力所及的，还有这个左右可以看到的一个视野。所以我们通常会听到人家住旅馆的时候会要求要一间视野不错的房间， a room with a good view。也就是说呢，这种房间的窗户能够看到窗外景色的房间。可是 scenery 的涵盖范围呢，比起 view 来是大多了。 scenery 指的是一个地方整体的一个景色，而不是像 view 一样是以观看者的角度来限定范围的。以此类推，我们所提到的这个 a room with a good view， 其实呢，它其实只是 part of the scenery 而已，只是这一部分的大风景里面的一小部分的地方而已。好，我们再回到我们对话的部分。So Sam said, "It must be great." 他很羡慕，他说应该很不错吧。I wish I could have the same experience too. How's the view on top of there? 他就说，真希望我也能有同样的经验呢。那你从上往下看的感觉是怎么样的呢？ Then Flora said.The view is spectacular. 他说那真是太棒了。It's hard to explain it by words. 他说那是太壮观了，壮观到我非常难用言语来做一个形容。And then she kept talking. She said, "You should have seen it through your eyes once, since you're in France now. For me, I feel like becoming a more open-minded person after viewing such."Beautiful scenery. 他说你人现在都到法国了，你真的应该要亲眼去看一次的。对我来说，在看过那样震撼的美景之后，我觉得我自己的心胸变得更为开阔了呢。 Sam said, "Wow, sounds great. I would definitely give it a try during my leisure time." 他说听起来真棒耶，我一定要利用我的空闲时间去看一下的。 Then Flora said, "Look at these pictures I took this morning.It is worthy to visit there. And you can easily get a whole picture of Paris from the top of there."
他说看看我经常拍的这些照片吧，去那边看看其实真的很有价值哦，而且你也可以获得一个巴黎市区的一个全景概念。
So Sam said, "Aren't you scared while looking down from the top of the Eiffel Tower because the tower is so high?"
他说埃菲尔铁塔那么高，你从上面往下看的时候，你会不会害怕呀？
Flora said, "Not if you look down literally."
他说只要你不是照字面上真是这样子直线往下看的话，你就不会害怕了。
You actually look in the far away distance and in all directions. You will simply admire how panoramic it is.
他说其实站在上面呢，是从各个方位去遥望远方，而且你会不自觉地赞叹那全景的美。
So Sam said, "Sounds like being encompassed by a scenic dream."
但是听起来像是被一片美景包围呢。
Then Flora said, "And you will have the same feeling when you are in the midst of masterpieces of the Palace of Louvre."
他说当你站在罗浮宫这一整片的艺术品中间的时候，其实你也会有同样的赞叹的。
So Sam asked, "So you have been to there too?"
他说你也去过了吗？
Flora said, "Yes, that's my schedule of yesterday."
他说是啊，我是昨天去的呢，那是我昨天的行程了。
So Sam asked, "It's often said that one day isn't enough for the lover."
他说事实上有人曾经说过说这呢是一天根本逛不完的。
Do you think that's true after you've been there yourself?
他说你现在已经亲身去体验过罗浮宫的壮丽了，你觉得这句话说的是对的吗？ Then Flora answered, I couldn't agree it more. There's possibility that one week or more would be needed. But none of us can have so much time for that, can we? 他说我完全同意啊，甚至我认为就算花上一两个礼拜也是必要的。可是事实上我们根本没有办法在那花那么长的时间。我们来做个补充，关于 I couldn't agree it more。 I couldn't agree it more 呢，其实是否定否定法，是双重否定的状态，负负得正，变成是我完全没有办法比现在再更认同你了。意思就是说呢，我非常的认同你，认同到了一个极限，无法比现在更认同你了。所以我们的 I couldn't agree with you more equals to I completely agree with you。 同样你也可以写成是 You can say that again， 你也可以再说一次我完全同意你的用法。来做一个小小的补充好了， I couldn't agree with you less 跟他刚刚那个只有差一点点的写法呢， I couldn't agree with you less 指的是 I completely disagree with you。这种用法呢非常的少用，那它跟刚刚我们所提到的这个 I couldn't agree with you more 呢是完全相反的，表示的是我完全无法认可你。那跟它有差不多意思还有像是 I couldn't care less or I couldn't agree with you less， 这表示的都是呢我完完全全不在意，我完完全全不了解的意思。好，我们再回到我们对话的部分。 Sam said You can say that again. By the wayIf you are not quite busy at this moment, perhaps you could do me a favor? 他说你说的对，他完完全全的赞同了。这时候他突然说了一句，班委对了，那如果你现阶段不忙的话，有没有兴趣来帮我一个忙呢？ So Flora said, well, it depends. What kind of help do you need? 他说那你需要我帮你什么忙呢？ Sam said, well, as you know,I'm a clothes designer, and I'm looking for someone to wear my clothes for photo shooting. 他说你知道的，我是一个服装设计师啊。那我现在正在找寻一个能穿着我设计的衣服拍照的模特。That's the reason why I'm on the street now. Are you interested? 他说这就是为什么我现在在这种时间我还可以在街上闲晃的原因了。那你有没有兴趣呢？ But Flora said, well, I'm not sure.Can I think about it for a couple days? 他说我不太能够肯定，可不可以让我考虑一下，考虑个几天呢？ Sam said, oh dear, time is limited. I need a model as soon as I can. Oops, a meeting is about to start, and I have to leave now. 他说我亲爱的， oh dear, 时间很紧迫呢。我是非常非常急需一个模特的。他突然间看了看时间，发现，嘿，我等一下有一个会议就要开始，现在就得离开了。So Flora said, sure, wish you luck. 他说好，祝你好运。You should be quick, don't be late for the meeting. 他说祝你好运呢，那你动作快一点，不要迟到了。So Sam said, thanks. Hey, think about the modeling thing, okay? And it's nice to see you here. 他就说谢啦，那你要记得想一下我说的那个 model 的事情，好不好？而且他最后又说了，真的很高兴可以在这里见到你呢。So Flora said, I think so too. You can always feel warm when you meet your friend accidentally in a foreign country. 他说是啊，在异乡可以意外的碰上朋友的时候，总是能轻易的感觉到一个温暖的感觉的。So Sam said, I will call you later today. Maybe we could have some French cuisine together this evening.他说我晚点再打电话给你好了，也许我们今晚是可以一起享用一个法国料理的。 So Flora said I'm looking forward to it. See you. 他说很期待啊，那先这样子哦，再见。好，那我们现在呢也先休息一下，接下来我们回来看一下我们今天到底说了些什么。好，欢迎回来。那我们今天的话呢就讲到这个地方结束了。不知道各位还记不记得我们今天说了些什么东西呢？我们提到说有一个人出国旅游的时候巧遇到自己的朋友出差，两个人小聊了一下，最后用了一个 I'm looking forward to it, see you 的结尾。 事实上呢，除了这种讲法之外，我们也可以说成是 I'm looking forward to seeing it。这个 look forward to 呢，后面我们只能接上名词或者是一个动名词 ving 的部分。那到底是要 simple present 这个主词加上 look forward to， 还是要用一个进行式的方式，主词加上 be 动词加上 looking forward to？ 好，其实呢，它们并没有差别。这个差异度呢，在于情感的一个强烈程度。我们使用进行式这个 ing 的状态的时候呢，其实跟我们简单式的原型动词相比较，进行式的情感比较强烈，也比较渴望。所以呢，如果说你要强调你是非常期待的时候，你就可以使用到进行式的方式了。那我们今天曾经提到的补充呢，第一个这个 such 的部分，我们之前呢也曾经提过 such， 我们跟 quite 跟 so 来做过比较，说我们拿 such 来形容一件事情的时候，感觉比较夸张。但是在这次在这一个章节的时候呢，我们是用来做感叹的一个动作，像是多么的，如此的。比方说我们举例说明的那个，这是个多么美丽的花园啊，那我们也提到总共有四种方式可以用来做补充，像是 It is such a beautiful garden， 或者是 It is so beautiful a garden， 我们也可以讲成是What a beautiful garden it is, or how beautiful garden it is. 那我们也提到过了，因为 what 跟 such 都是一个感叹形容词的部分，所以它后面呢都可以直接修饰一个完整的名词片语 ，a beautiful garden. 可是呢，我们的 how 跟我们的 so， 它们呢都是属于感叹副词的部分，后面呢都需要直接接上一个形容词来做修饰。所以我们原本完整的这个 a beautiful garden 这个中间的这个形容词 beautiful 就被提到副词的后面来做一个修饰。那接下来我们也提到 view 跟 scenery 的对比比较，所以我们也知道说 view 呢代表是我们人视线所及的一个范围，但是包括在 scenery 这个一整个地方整体景观景色的单字里面，所以我们就知道啦 a room with a good viewWell, actually, it is only part of the scenery. 它只是在这 scenery 中间的一小部分而已。那在最后的地方，我们也特别提到了 I couldn't agree it more. 他说呢，我真的完完全全没有办法再认同你了。这是一个双重否定的用法，意思是我完全没有办法比现在更认同你，我已经认同你到了一个极限。那它的同义词，我们也可以说成像是 Hey, you can say that again.Or, I completely agree with you. 那跟它相反呢，则是 I couldn't agree with you less, or I completely disagree with you. 表示是我完完全全无法认同你的部分。那我们也提到跟它有类似的，像是 I couldn't care less， 表示是我完完全全不在意。那这些东西呢，都是双重否定的部分，负负得正反而变成了肯定。好，今天呢，这是我们这学期的最后一堂课了。也希望各位同学在经过这一整个学期的这种课、这个训练之后，会发现其实开口说英文没有那么难。生活处处呢都可以使用到英文的地方，从小做起，你也能够发现到，其实英文之于我们没有那么难，就像中文一样，总是可以自然的找到一个地方，找到一个机会可以让你说到、说出英文。那我们这一学期呢，这两个学期24个讲次。甚至最后还有英语绘画三、英语绘画四的部分，你们也可以学到更多更多的机会，可以让你们知道说到底英文是怎么样的。好，那希望各位同学真的学到了些什么。那我们下学期再见喽，拜拜。